Dr. Jeff Sherman here with freshman Amber Thompson. Amber, talk to me a little bit about, you didn't qualify the way you wanted to. Ideally, you qualified 14th. You ended up running into Lindenwood University in the first round of match play. National power, 2006 national champion. Tell me your thoughts going into that match.
It's nerve-wracking knowing that you're going up against some girls that are really good. And being a young team, I mean, we don't have as much experience in the same position that they do. So it was exciting knowing that, yeah, we can do it. We've been up next to them, and we saw how they bowled, and we knew we could do it. It was definitely an experience. It was exciting, and to take them four games, it's even more exciting.
Yeah, sweeping them. A phrase was shared by one of your coaches with me after the match. That was, we put our foot on their throat and didn't let off. Is that the way you would describe sweeping Lindenwood?
That is exactly how I would describe it. You know, we won the first game, and then the second game was close, and you know, just never let up and never back down. You know, we made shots when we needed to, and there were a couple situations where we needed a double or we needed a spare, and our girls really stepped up and made that happen. And it was such a good feeling to, I mean, only go four games. It seems like all of our last match play events, we've taken it to the max. We, you know, if it's a five-game series, we take it to all five games. You know, we always make it, like, put the pressure on ourselves. And now it was exciting to not do that and to just take it four games.
You went to seven with Pikeville.
It's
great match. 2008 champions. You ran into the 2006 champions in the first round and the 2008 champions in the second round. Talk to me about that match.
It's just, it's something that I think our team, our girls have been like used to. It's, we've done it. We did it in the conference finals. Every time we're in a match play situation, I feel like we take it to the max. And you know, when we get down, we don't get down on ourselves. We always think, hey, you know, there's another game. So there's more time to make up. And it seems like there's always one girl on our team that's friends with another girl on the other team. So, you know, we just cut the friendship for a second. We're here to bowl. And if it takes seven games to beat you, that's what it takes.
Shifting gears a little bit. Tell me a little bit about how it felt to be here with this specific team. You guys have developed relationships. Tell me about how it felt to bowl with the ladies you bowled with.
This is a great group of ladies. I've never wanted to be around a certain group more than I want to be around these girls. It was really nice being a freshman, coming in, and these girls all welcomed me with open arms, you know. And I'm friends with everyone. They've kind of taken me under their wing, and you know, they've taught me things that I didn't know just as well as I felt like I taught them things that they didn't know. It's a good experience to be here as a freshman, and you know, you never want to take anything for granted, but I definitely see us coming back here in the years coming, and it's just a great group to be around, and I think this was a great experience for all of us and something that we can all build off of for the upcoming years.
You had your final match today, a 4-3 defeat to Stephen F. Austin. One of your coaches has also used the word clutch in describing you. Did some specific things happen in that match that maybe somebody would say she's clutch?
I think what I guess proved myself in a clutch situation was at the Lindenwood match. I needed a double in the 10th frame. To just totally win it, I needed a double and a good count. And the first shot was iffy, but it struck, and that's what matters. And the second shot was much better, and it struck. So, I mean, and then at that point, I could give the fill ball to somebody else that'll just keep it on the lane, so we win the match. And win by two or however many we won by. And, you know, I feel like I've been put in that situation a lot in my life. Most of the time, it's an individual thing. So, you know, you kind of want to do it for yourself. And now you've got six other girls standing behind you cheering for you to do it. And then you do it. And it's a good feeling. It's more of the feeling, not that you just made two great shots, but knowing that everybody behind you has a little sigh of relief and they feel good about it too. So, It's a good feeling.
How would you characterize this experience at the national championships?
It was something I didn't really know what to expect when we came. And I was texting my parents. I'm like, this is really cool. Like, I've never put a tag on my bag before with my name on it. That's the coolest thing ever. It's so silly. But it was the little things that were the coolest experience for me. And sharing this opportunity and everything with the people that are here with us and the men's team. It's probably one of the greatest feelings ever. I mean, it's very exciting.
Thank you, Amber.